Ah, not bad. I made it live. I made it in time for Poco DCG Gamer versus Lighthouses OUPL Week 2 Sun and Moon OU. So we see a really cool balance slash bulky offense from Poco DCG Gamer with Tornadus, Gastrodon. Damn, I like these mons, dude. But Lighthouse is packing the Nidoking. I assume it's gonna be Mega Metagross is still allowed, so I think it might be Fizzdev Gastrodon to check Metagross. Otherwise he's gonna rely on pivoting around, getting some helmet damage. If he's defensive Landorus, he could also be Rockstrain, obviously. So I think DCG Gamer, like, he doesn't necessarily have to have a Scarfer, but he could be he has a Zygarde, which is like one of his ways to check Volk, and a Torn. But Torn is not the best Volk check since you have to hit Hurricanes. Like, I'm just trying to look at a stream structure and trying to find out what the Scarfer is. So it could be Scarf Granded check Volcarona, but I'm not really the biggest fan of Scarf Granded. We will see. I mean, he has priority in ESP, he has a bulky core, he doesn't need a Scarf, I wanna, like I say. But yeah. I think Lighthouse is Brazilian, but not 100% sure. Let me know if you see this. And he's out with Kelio, which is probably Scarf Kelio. Megina could be Z-Move, Assault Vest, and that's, oh my lord, that's a life of Tornadus. I was about to say that's an offensive Tornadus, because that knockoff did so much. So now that we know it's not Assault Vest Torn, it's probably not, I don't think it's Fizzdev Gastrodon, because I was going off this being AV Torn at first and Fizzdev Gastrodon, but now we have to go off this being probably Spadev Gastrodon to check Ashgren, or just Greninja in general, even Protein, because there was a Skunk Shot, which is like the physical move that Gren gets, and if you are Spadev and you're immune to Hydro Pump, if you have Storm Drain, so you check Greninja pretty well. So like the best thing Greninja can do is get up spikes, or fish for Gunshot Poison, or fish for crits or flinches. Yeah, obviously the Ashgren can fish for flinches to try and get up his Ash form, but I don't know if that's a reliable strategy. It's like, I think it needs two flinches to beat Gastrodon on one. So like Gastrodon is pretty nice to check that, as that Toxic Mist sucks a lot. Like, yeah, he doesn't have Greninja Switch, and so I think it's AV Megina. Z-Move Lari, or, I think Nidoking would be Life Orb, like, that's just for consistent damage output with Cheer Force. Landorus would be Rocks, I think, as that's maybe Specs Lari, because that Draco did a lot to Heatran. Depending on the Heatran spread. Like, if it's max HP Heatran, I think there has to be Specs Lari. Let me run some Calc for you guys. As yeah, I assume the Heatran is gonna go for Rocks or Toxic here. Could I add probably Magma Trend? It's like the most common set at the moment. Heatran versus Latios. So, Life of Latios, Drago does 42-37. I did 42. And he went from Magma Storm and did a lot to Nidoking, so I assume he's offensive. So. Heatran. Yeah, so to no bulk, to no HP Heatran. Yeah, I think so. This Heatran has probably some bulk, or he just got a low roll on the Specs Lardy. Like, Specs Draco does 46 to 54 to no HP Heatran. So it had to be some HP invested trend. I don't know if it's max HP. Oh, it could also be Sol Dulari and no HP Heatran potential. Yeah, that's an option, I think, yeah. But yeah, the Nidoking will outspeed this Heatran. Unless he's running Modest. I assume he's gonna go Torn or Gastro. Oh, he goes Torn and catches him with the Ice Beam. Nice play by Lighthouse. But yeah, Torn lives one. But he doesn't wanna necessarily go attack here because he would die to Life Orb Recoil. But yeah, I assume Lighthouse is gonna go to Zapdos. doubles out in the guest with Patrick Dinard as, oh my lord, what a good play, what a great play there, going for off pro. I already like this game, like both players making plays, so this is a cool game. I mean, Lighthouse is making an aggressive play there with Nidoking, but it didn't really do much since the guest was for death. Could just recover it off anyway, but it was a cool play in general. So I don't know what the Zlati could do to the Gastron. Like, how does Zlati threaten this? I don't... Like, if it's Specs, it can trick it, but I don't think it's Specs anymore, because I calc'd then. Unless the Heatran had HP, like that Draco did too little. Okay, see, that did 45. See, like, okay, I'm not sure anymore. Did 45. Yeah, but Specs does 46 to 54 to no HP trend. And I assume it's max speed, max special attack trend, like, not sure. I guess it could be a mix between HP and speed on a Heatran. I'm pretty sure Gastron would have eaten that up and could have gone for recover. But yeah, so I assume this is like... We see leftover, so it's not Z move. I assume it's Z move Zygarde or Lando. Don't think it would be Gren Z move. Z move Gren. Goes for Magma Storm, hits thankfully, gets rid of the Nidoking. Which Nidoking wasn't super scary, but it was a threat. Like, I guess everyone has to spam recover with Nidoking to stay healthy, and like if he gets a crit, that can get annoying. But yeah, I assume he's gonna go into his own Lando or into... I don't know. He doesn't really have good switch-ins to Lando. I mean, he can stay in predicting Lighthouses to go for rocks. Which would be an aggressive play. Rocks are kind of nice because Pokuji's G Gamer doesn't have hazard removal. Yeah. So it's tempting to click the rocks here if you Lighthouses. As he just makes a safe play. I can completely understand that you just want to make a safe play. You don't want to get bopped by Magma Storm, but. Like, rocks are just so nice. Like, why not get him up? I mean, he gets him up now, but. So they're both rocks land, okay. So other moves on Pokedex GG Gamma Trend. Probably Toxic. Maybe Taunt. And probably Off Par. Or potentially Roar to Faith, but I don't think that would be. I mean, Roar would be an option if he spikes on Greninja to like get good damage if he has rocks and spikes up on the opposing team, but not sure. If Roar is the last move on Trend. So yeah, I assume one of the two Landers might be Z-move. Like, we already know it's leftover Zapdos that got knocked off. So if it's not Z-move Mugina, I think it would be Z-move Lando. With Rocks, Earthquake, Stone Edge, Sword Stance potentially, Scarf Killed, Soldo or Specs Lati, still not 100% sure, depending on the Heatran spread. It could also be Scarf Lati and he got a high roll, I don't know about that. No, I don't think Scarf Lati would do so much damage to Heatran, it did like way too much, even if the Trend has no HP. Like, I didn't calc Scarf Lati, but I don't think it is. No, that makes no sense. He has to be Scarf Killed to check Volk. Unless, like, Scarf Lati runs T-Wave sometimes to check Volk Corona, but that's not really, like, reliable. T-Wave can also miss this gen. But yeah, I think PokéGG Gamer's Lando has HPIs. Both Landers could be HPIs, but I think he could be a Zemus Zygarde, which would be really cool to see put in some work. But yeah, not sure about the Z-move yet on his team. Okay, my prediction was correct. He's probably STZ move. But yeah, he goes for U-turn there, which is a cool play. Grabs him the momentum. So I don't know if he has HBIs if he went for U-turn. U-turn, I can understand. Even if he has HBIs, I can understand U-turning, potentially trying to catch. Because I would have probably gone Kaldu there if I was Lighthouse freaking HBIs. So U-turn makes a lot of sense. And yeah, you can go Greninja here. Yeah, Greninja is fine. And go for Hydro Pump, like. Or like you can be like aggressive and go for spikes, but if you have it, but Hydro Pump should be free. Unless you miss. Or Ice Beam, like whatever he is. Ashcram with spikes has been so common. I don't know if he would be that on this team. I think he's Protein. That's usually what you see when there's two water types. But that's not like set into stone. You can obviously be both grand versions. Okay, he decides to make Torn play, so this makes me think he's HBI's Torn. So if I'm Lighthouse, I'd probably go Keldeo here. Oh, Zap. No, not Zapdos. Zapdos takes a lot with rocks and. Keldeo or McGee, and I probably Keldeo. Go Zapdos. Okay. On a Hurricane. Okay, so I don't know if he doesn't have HBIs or if he just made a risky prediction there. Predicting the Keldeo on the potential HBIs, because I would have gone Keldeo. I would have gone Barth by Pokédex G-Gamer the God. But yeah, he's just gonna switch, hard switch out. Even if he has U-turn, I don't think he wants to take the extra life orb. So I think he's gonna go hard gas around here. But yeah, Lighthouses can't really afford to double switch, because in case he U-turns, that doesn't help him. So yeah, Roost makes sense. Like, he doesn't have anything to touch this. If he doesn't have Toxic on Zapdos, Gastrodon just wars it forever. Unless, like, he can go for Heat Wave Burn if he has that. I assume he's Roost. If he's not Defog Lardy, he's Defog Zapdos, Roost Defog, Heat Wave, and Discharge, or Discharge and HBIs. But yeah, Gastrodon already showed Toxic, so he might go Megina this time. But Megina doesn't beat Gastrodon unless it's like. No, I don't think Megina beats it, but he's gonna try to pivot on the Toxic, which he gets. That gets that correct. I think he's gonna try to pivot into Lardy or something, but not really sure. Maybe he's like I'm pretty sure this is Assault Vest Megina. It's like Flurricane doesn't do enough. Like, he can just recover that off. So like, he can go for Scald. Like, I think he's trying to bring the Lardy in on the Earth Power, but like I said earlier, I don't even think Lardy beats Gastrodon 1v1, so I'm not sure. Like, this Gastrodon just walls the entire team besides Landorus that got up an ST. So yeah, not really sure how Lighthouses can win this. I mean, yeah, Pokédex G-Gamer considering all options here. Like, I think Megina has access to Energy Ball, but that's not really a set. But yeah, he just recovers it off, which is what I was talking about. Like, this doesn't beat Gastrodon. But I guess he's kind of trying to. He has to somehow stall out the Gastrodon's recovers. The Gastrodon has 14 left, though, so that's gonna take a while. And in the process where he stalls out those recovers and keeps attacking, his monster will probably lose some health, too. Especially if that Toxic on Lardy hit earlier, this Lardy would have been so low. But yeah, this is a free Toxic, I think, because the Megina's not staying in here. Scald or Toxic, but I think Toxic is fine here. Like, even if the Megina stays in, it's not going to do any damage unless it crits. But he stays in, predicting the Toxic. But yeah, he gets the play correct, but this doesn't do anything for him. Like, Gastrodon can Toxic again here. Toxic again. He's trying to bring the Lardy in and recover. Okay, so here, Lighthouse has played that well, but I think I would have just gone for Toxic again. Because the Megina just kept lowering its special attack. But yeah, he played that. I can see that. That was some tactical maneuver. But yeah, like I said, I don't think Vladdy beats the Gastrodon, but I can understand that PokéGG Gamma doesn't want to necessarily stay in here. Because the Gastrodon basically walls the entire team. Like, he can just recover off a Draco. I don't think a Psyshock or Psychic would do enough, like. So I think he can go for Toxic, like, besides the risk getting crit, but he sacks the Tren. Yeah, Psyshock is a 2-8 KO. I don't think he's gonna pivot out here unless he thinks it's choice Vladdy's. Like, he will know from his, he knows his Heatran spread. I don't know his Heatran spread. I don't think it's choice Vladdy. Okay, but him going into Keldeo makes me, so okay, so this confirms it's choice Vladdy. Him going into Keldeo, I think, because like he brought this in like knew, like as if he knew it was locked into Psyshock. So like that was a good play by Lighthouse. But maybe it is Specs Vladdy then, and the Heatran has some HP investment. That makes sense, yeah. Like, I obviously don't know his Heatran spread. If I knew his spread, I could calc. I mean, I could find out if I like, but I don't use Heatran much at the moment, so I don't. Like, I'm not really that much. I don't have the information what is really common at the moment. A Secret Sword is a good play there, catching the Gastro. But PokéGG Gamma doesn't lose anything for making the Gastrodon play. All he loses is another recover PP. So he has 12 left because he has to recover here. So I don't know. Yeah, okay. Brings back in the Vladdy. And so he basically has to sack the Tren now. I mean, I can understand him going Gastrodon was a safe play, but yeah, if you flex, he could have gone Landris, because like, with a Gastrodon around, like, there's no way the Kelly would go for a water move. Unless you feel like making a wild prediction. I mean, the next time, I would consider the next time if I would go for a water move, like, if he keeps going Gastrodon, he will eventually not go Gastrodon anymore and try to catch you on Scald potentially if he goes low on recover, so I might try to change it up then. But yeah, the first few times I would obviously spam Secret Sword. As yeah, the Heatran gets sacked off, and the Greninja can come out here, or the, yeah, the Greninja is gonna come out here. You can also go to Tornadus and click U-turn. Zygarde probably lives with Spec Psyshock too, so Zygarde could, I don't know if it's Dragon Dance Z-move Zygarde, but I think it's Z-move Zygarde. Like, just from what we have seen so far, I don't think it would be Z-move Gren. And yeah, I'm 100% certain that it's Z-move Land on Lighthouse's team. Yeah, I love narrating these live. Like, it's like kind of easier for me to look at the teams. I get a little bit more time. When I look at the replays, I kind of make some mispredictions sometimes because I don't get that much time to look at the teams. Because like, when it happens live, it's just cooler. So we see it's probably Scarf Gren as he shows Protein U-turn, which is, I think it's only run on Scarf Gren. Like U-turn on Protein. Like Ash runs it too sometimes in Specs, but like in Protein. It's not really a set, like in Protean. I think he's gonna like make a mid ground play, which is like Scald in case he goes Magina. Or he doubles out in the turn, gets some regen that way. Like if he switches out now, he gets some regen. Rocks do, I think, 25 and regen heals 33. I don't know why I said I think. I know Rocks do that much. But yeah, it's obviously Assault with Magina. As he sacks off his turn, I know that he, like, I know that I can understand that you don't want to go Gastrodon and waste more of your recovers, but I'm not really sure. Like, I feel like there was a free Scald with the Gastrodon where he switched on the Taunt that turn. But yeah, he'll have a reason why he made that play. Oh yeah, I think he predicted the Latios. Yeah, that was a good play. It's like the Latios comes in on the Gastrodon. And basically gets a kill. Cause like missing that Toxic Ally was so huge, like oh my lord. Yeah, yeah, so that made sense. He doubled in the Thornbridge and the Lati. Didn't want to give the Lati a kill. Like, Lati doesn't get a kill 100% if it comes in, but, like, it's risky. Like, he cannot just go Greninja, because he could potentially Draco. And Sashuk would do a lot to Gastrodon. So I can get behind the play he made. And, yeah. I think you go for Toxic here, breaking the Lati. Lighthouses can also just sack this Mikina. I mean, it's still nice to have. But he can sack it and then gets his Lati in, basically. Not risking anything, but I think going hard Lati is fine too. So I Scald a Toxic here. This is tough now for Poké CG Gamer. He might lose this. Yeah, goes for Earthquake, makes the correct play. Did I say off power earlier? Yeah, Gastrodon runs minus speed nature, they run Earthquake, Scald, Recover, Toxic. Some run Curse, but yeah, this isn't Curse. If it's Toxic, Recover, Earthquake, Scald is pretty much staple. On Curse, I've seen Waterfall. Jambat used that in last gen, but yeah, this one isn't Curse, unless he's no water move, Gastro. Yeah, yeah, I remember this Lati should be dead. Yeah, you're right. Well, this gets a kill now with Draco. You can heal his Gastro, or you can go Greninja here, but this is pretty bad. Oh, I don't know if Zaga would live a minus 2 Draco and could go for Dragon Dance, but Keldeo still outspeeds Zygarde and probably takes E-Speed from the range it's at, which is like 66 after Rock. Like, I don't know, I think it's DDZ move Zygarde, but not 100% sure. Could still be banned Zygarde. I don't think it's subcard on this team. Oh well. I mean, this is the only way you can stop the god of Poké CG Gamer. Like, he's a god, like, I think he's in OU circuit, however you pronounce that, and like round 10. I think he beat FLCL last round, if I recall correctly. Not 100% sure about that. You can correct me if I'm wrong. But he's like in winner's bracket, like. I didn't know too much about this tournament, otherwise I would have recorded the series. But yeah, I'll try to record some of that if I can catch it. But my focus is obviously on. At the moment, it's on OUPL at the weekend, during the weekend, and like World Cup is gonna be coming up in like 2 or 3 weeks, I think in 3 weeks. So yeah, that's gonna overlap with OUPL and World Cup, so that's gonna take some. Whew, that's gonna be hype, even though like US East, I think they have like the strongest team every time, so that's not really fair. And like Germany was in finals last year, so. They did pretty well, but some of the good players stopped, and a lot of the German players are not that good at in Sun and Moon. From what I've seen, well, from what I like compared to US East, I think Germany's not that strong Sun and Moon. But yeah, we have other tiers in World Cup, so maybe Germany can pull it through. Like, I'm German, so this is why I'm mentioning this. Like, I'm rooting for them. But yeah, Scarf Ice Beam comes out, Kelios free there. Like, he was going for Dark Pulse or Ice Beam there, like, what else would he have? Like, Scarf Grunt doesn't really run Dark Pulse, but you never know. And he's gonna go Secret Sword to it, KO the Gastro, gets a crit, so one it KOs. And if it's DD Zygarde, this can still win. I hope it's DD Zygarde. Please be that set. But yeah, he also has Landorus with Intimidate, so it's kinda rough, and now Landorus might die after Rocks to Devastating Drake if it's that sad. Like Z Outrage. Please put in some work with a Zygarde, that would be so cool. But yeah, I think Lighthouse should win this if he makes the correct play here. Let me see. The Greninja can actually win if he lets the Kellyo, if he sacks the Kellyo, so Ice Beam just sweeps everything if Kellyo dies, so Lighthouse has to play careful here. It's kinda actually Zapdos might live Ice Beam because it's Scarf Gwen. It's not Life Orb. So yeah. Goes into Landris. I hope we see a Dragon Dance. We do see a Dragon Dance, let's go! So, if he DDs again, doesn't he just win with this? Oh, he can call if Devastating Drake kills, let me do the same. Zygarde versus... I know I have the other Zygarde in the calc, but... They have the same attacks that if I recall correctly. Put Adamant, let me put Outrage, let me put Z Outrage. Versus Offensive Landris. There's 96 to 130. Okay, so he goes for another Dragon Dance. Eats up the Earthquake. And I think this Zygarde wins. You can go for a Z move here. Because you don't want to lock into Outrage. I guess Lighthouse could pivot. Yeah, Lighthouse could pivot out to save Intimidate. That was a good play. As he goes for the Z move there. Lord, that was a good play. If he did it again, that would have been super over. Yeah, that was a good play by Lighthouse's good Lord. He got that play correct. Dang. So if he just outraged that in. Nah, he didn't, but if he outraged there. If he did it again, he probably won. That was kind of 50-50, but that was well played. That kills, good Lord. I didn't think that would kill. Yeah, okay, I forgot it was an offensive Landris. Makes sense that it kills, and it's at neutral. So this Zygarde might win. Yes, Scarf Greninja should win. My Lord, stop this man. Even Hex can't stop him. Like, Outrage brings this into range from Greninja's... actually, he can still lose, yeah. If he hits him, he can hit himself potentially, and... We shall see how it plays out. But yeah, if the Zapdos has HPIs, he can pick off the Zygarde here. Or he can just Roost Spam, try to get the Zygarde to hit itself in Confusion. And I don't know what move Greninja has. If Greninja has like extra sensory, it can win. Okay, he decides to make the Roost play and bank on this hitting himself. But yeah, if he doesn't hit himself, he wins. As he hits himself, come on. Good Lord. Well, that's Pokemon for you. Yeah, well, this series between Manibarx, BBC Kings, and I forgot who they're playing, but it sucks a lot. Like, Finch got a win because, like, his opponent, Gypsy, like, timed out, and now they get a win because of Hex. Like, no, nothing against them. That's Pokemon for you. Like, if you play this game, you know what. Like, you could just HPI the first time. I mean, yeah, it's Garf Gren. It could have gone with Gunshot. I'm not sure if it could have gone with Gunshot. But yeah, now he's going for Rock Slide Fringes. That's his only play. There's not such a thing as Garf Gun. So yeah, can we get some justice and get a flinch on a Kellyo here? I think we need like one or two flinches. Yeah, you need two flinches. He's not getting two. Yeah, okay. Well, Poké TCG Gamer loses. Only Hex can stop the god. And... yeah, so I was talking about this. It's Manibarx team. Score was 2-2, and now they're on the back. 2-3. Oh yeah, Teal lost versus Eternal. That was also Hexy a bit. And now it's Hexy again. After they were up 2-0, they're 2-3, which sucks. So they have to bring it back in Black, White, DPP, and ADV. They can still bring it back, yeah. Nakova skill is really good in Black and White, but I don't know if I'll record that, because it's not really the biggest fan of those two. I don't have the knowledge. But yeah, it was a cool game nonetheless. I got most of the sets correct, which is cool, because like sometimes I just get them completely wrong. And yeah, I'm hyped for to see Ricardo play with Vucevic later, and my dude Easy versus Steve Angelo, and Paulus J stays. I hope that game is happening and they're not gonna get subbed out. Hope you guys all enjoyed, and let's upload this. This is fresh.